Now let us solve the next question. Find 14 divided by 5 by 6, 4 divided by 8 by 3, and 5 divided by 3, 4 by 7. So if you observe all these divisions, in each case a whole number is divided by the fraction. So this is the case where we divide a whole number by a fraction. So here we can write that whole number divided by fraction. So when we divide a whole number by the fraction, then we write the same as whole number is multiplied by the reciprocal of the fraction. So what is the reciprocal of 5 by 6? So we know that the reciprocal of 5 by 6 is 6 by 5. Now we know that how to multiply a fraction with a whole number. Then to multiply fraction with whole number, we just multiply the whole number with the numerator of the fraction. So then we get 14 into 6 by 5. Now this equals to, now we multiply 14 and 6, 6 for the 24, and 6 1 the 6 plus 2 8, 84 by 5. So this is an improper fraction, so we can convert into the mixed fraction. So if 84 is divided by 5, then we get 5 1s are 5, so 8 minus 5 is 3, then carry 4 here, so then we got 34, then 5 6 are 30, so the remainder is 4. We can write 4 by 5. So this 84 by 5 can be written as 16 4 by 5. So if you divide 14 by 5 by 6, we get the quotient 16 4 by 5. Now let us solve the next question. 4 divided by 8 by 3. So here also a whole number is divided by the fraction. Now to divide the whole number by fraction, so we multiply the whole number by the reciprocal of the fraction. Now what is the reciprocal of 8 by 3? So it is 3 by 8. Now this equals to, now we multiply whole number with numerator of the fraction. So 4 into 3 divided by 8. Now here we can cancel 4 and 8. 4 1s are 4 and 4 2s are 8. Then we get 3 by 2, because 1 3s are 3 by 2. And this is also an improper fraction, so we can convert into the mixed fraction by dividing 3 by 2. So if 3 is divided by 2, 2 1s are 2, the remainder is 1. So this we can add 1 by 2. Now this equals to 1 1 by 2. Next one, 5 divided by 3, 4 by 7. So here a whole number is divided by a mixed fraction. So first we convert the mixed fraction into the improper fraction. Now this equals to 5 divided by 7, 3 is 21 plus 4, 25 divided by 7. Now 5 is multiplied by the reciprocal of the fraction. So reciprocal of 25 by 7 is 7 by 25. Then we write 7 by 25. Then we multiply whole number with numerator of the fraction, then we get 5 into 7 by 25. So here also we can cancel 5 and 25. 5 1s are 5, 5 5s are 25, then we get 1 7s are 7 by 5. So this is also an improper fraction. We can convert into the mixed fraction. So we divide 7 by 5, 5 1s are 5, the remainder is 2. So we write 2 by 5. So this can be written as 1 2 by 5 in the mixed fraction form. Now let us solve the next question. Find 7 by 3 divided by 2, 6 by 13 divided by 7, and 3 1 by 2 divided by 4. So if you observe all these divisions, then each case a fraction is divided by the whole number. Now this is the case we divide a fraction by a whole number. So we can write fraction divided by whole number. Now when you divide any fraction by the whole number, then we write the fraction as it is, 7 by 3, and we write multiplication symbol, then we write the reciprocal of this whole number. So what is the reciprocal of the whole number 2? So it is 1/2. Now we multiply both numerators and both denominators. So 7 × 1/3 × 2. So this equals to 7 × 1 = 7 / 3 × 2 = 6. So this is an improper fraction. So we can convert into the mixed fraction by dividing 7 by 6. 6 × 1 = 6. 7 − 6 = 1. So we can write 1/6. So this equals to 1/6. Now here also a fraction is divided by the whole number. So to divide a fraction by the whole number, we multiply the fraction 6/13 by the reciprocal of 7. So that is 1/7. So here also, now to divide a fraction by whole number, we multiply the fraction by the reciprocal of the whole number 7. So the reciprocal of 7 is 1/7. Now to multiply these two fractions, we just multiply both numerators and both denominators of the two fractions. Now here we multiply 6 and 1, so 6 × 1, and we multiply both denominators, so 13 × 7. Here we cannot cancel any numerator with any denominator, so we multiply 6 × 1 = 6 / 13 × 7 = 91. Next, 3 1/2 / 4. So this is a mixed fraction. So 3 1/2 is a mixed fraction. So first we will convert into the improper fraction. Now this equals to 2 3 = 6 + 1 = 7/2 / 4. Now to divide 7/2 / 4, we multiply the fraction 7/2 by the reciprocal of the whole number 4. So what is the reciprocal of the 4? It is 1/4. Now this equals to, we multiply both numerators 7 × 1 by both denominators 2 × 4. So this equals to 7 × 1 = 7 / 2 = 8. So this is the product and it is a proper fraction. Now let us solve the next question. Find 4/9 / 2/3, 3 1/2 / 8/3, and 3 1/5 / 1 / 2/3. So if you observe all these fractions in each case, means if you observe all these divisions in each case, a fraction is divided by another fraction. Now this is the case we divide a fraction by another fraction. So we write fraction divided by fraction. Now let us solve the first question in this. Now 4/9 / 2/3. So to divide a fraction by another fraction, we multiply 4/9, the first fraction 4/9, by the reciprocal of the second fraction 2/3. So what is the reciprocal of 2/3? It is 3/2. Now we write the reciprocal of 2/3 as 3/2. Then to multiply the two fractions 4/9 and 3/2, so we multiply both numerators and both denominators. So we write 4 × 3 / 9 × 2. So here we can cancel 4 and 2. 2 × 1 = 2 and 2 × 2 = 4. Here also we can cancel 3 and 9. So 3 × 1 = 3 and 3 × 3 = 9. So this equals to 2 × 1 = 2 / 3 × 1 = 3. So this is a proper fraction. Next question. 3 1/2 / 8/3. So yeah, 3 1/2 is a mixed fraction. We should convert into the improper fraction. So this equals to 2 3 = 6 + 1 / 7/2 / 8/3. To divide 7/2 / 8/3, so we multiply 7/2 by the reciprocal of 8/3. So this equals to 7/2 into the reciprocal of 8/3 is 3/8. Now this equals to, now to multiply the two fractions, we multiply both numerators and both denominators. Now 7 × 3 / 2 × 8. So this equals to 7 3s are 21 by 2 8s are 16. So this is an improper fraction. We can convert into the mixed fraction. So we divide 21 by 16. So 16 ones are 16. So 11 minus 6 is 5. We can write 5 by 16. So this equals to 1 5 by 16. So this is the quotient of 3 1 by 2 divided by 8 by 3. Next question, 3 1 by 5 divided by 1 2 by 3. Now this is the case we divide a mixed fraction by another mixed fraction. Now first we will convert the mixed fractions into the improper fractions. Now this equals to 5 3s are 15 plus 1 16 by 5 divided by 3 1s are 3 plus 2 5 5 by 3. Now to divide 16 by 5 by 5 by 3, so we multiply 16 by 5 by the reciprocal of 5 by 3. So this can be written as 16 by 5 into the reciprocal of 5 by 3 is 3 by 5. Now we will multiply both numerators and both denominators. So 16 into 3 by 5 into 5. So this equals to 16 3s are 48 by 5 5s are 25. Now this is also an improper fraction. We can convert into the mixed fraction. So let us divide 48 by 25. So 25 ones are 25 and 8 minus 5 is 3. 4 minus 2 is 2. So we can write 23 by 25. So this equals to 1 23 by 25. So far we have learnt the fractions, means types of fractions, and the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of fractions and their properties. And we have also learnt about reciprocal of fractions. Now let us shift to the topic decimal numbers. Now you have already learnt about decimal numbers in your previous classes. Now let us recall a few concepts regarding the decimal numbers. Now if you expand any decimal number like 432.468, then so what is the place value of 2 here? So it is in 1's place and 3 in 100's place and 4 in 1000's place. Then what is the place value of 4? So it is quite right to the decimal point. So its place value is tenths. And 6 is in hundredths. And 8 is in thousandths.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.